I used to run my entire business with a simple to-do list. I think that this is how a lot of people manage their tasks that they need to take care of, by writing down a list of them. Of course, different people have different systems for their to-do lists. Some people write a new to-do list every day. Some people have a giant to-do list that they are constantly adding things to. Some people make random little to-do lists and then try not to lose them. And I would say that I was pretty good at making to-do lists. I tried to keep one master to-do list that said everything I needed to do, and then I would also make to-do lists for each day. So I had a pretty good system going on. But the bigger my business got, the more my business grew, the more out of control things got, the more out of control things felt, and the more overwhelmed I felt. It was just a lot to manage with to-do lists, but I didn't really have an idea for what I could do instead. I didn't know what else to do aside from just to get as much on my calendar as I could. So I had a calendar and I had these to-do lists and I tried to keep them organized, but a lot of the time I found myself procrastinating on things or avoiding certain projects because I felt so stressed out by everything that had to get done. And that was kind of just how things continued, me just trying to keep up, until I found Asana. Asana is a free app that you can use on desktop or on mobile, and I found it a couple years ago when I hired my operations manager, Courtney. She introduced me to Asana and helped me get it all set up, and honestly, my life has never been the same. So in this video, I'm just going to take you behind the scenes into my Asana account and show you exactly how I have things organized there and how I use Asana to run my entire business. So if that sounds interesting to you and you want to snoop into how my business is organized and how I manage to get a lot of things done every single day, every single week, every single month, then just keep on watching. Okay, so let me show you inside my Asana account so you can understand what I'm talking about and how this all works. Basically, in Asana, you have these different projects and they are all organized over here in this left menu, and you can click on them to access each of the projects. And in each of the projects, there are lists of tasks that need to get done. The projects have different views that you can look at them in. So this project, for example, is in the list view, whereas this project up here is in the board view, where we've got these columns with different cards on them. But you can also look at the projects in calendar view, where you see all the tasks on a calendar, or you can look at them in timeline view, where you see how the projects are overlapping or not with each other, which can help you to make sure that your projects are spread out enough and in the right order, so that maybe if you have something that you need to do before something else, they have the correct dates to make that happen. Now, as I said, in each of these projects, there are tasks. And what's nice about these tasks is that they're all organized into projects, so there aren't any miscellaneous tasks floating around. And the tasks that are due today automatically pop into this list of tasks that is due today. Now, whenever you create a new task, you can assign it to a certain person and with a particular due date, and of course, you'll give it a name. And you can also add all sorts of other information like details into the description, or you could attach pictures or any other sort of file. But what's really cool about this is when you create a new task, it automatically pops into the recently assigned category, as you can see right here, but then you can sort it into your upcoming tasks and it disappears. It disappeared down here into this upcoming category. And there's a gazillion things down there, but I don't have to look at them because on the day that that task is in fact due, it's going to automatically pop into my today task list. And what this means is that I don't have to think about the future. I don't have to worry about the future. I only have to worry about today. But I'm not ignoring the future. The future is carefully and strategically planned. I just don't have to worry about it because it's going to take care of itself. On the days when I need to do things, they're going to pop into my today to-do list, and I'll take care of them on the right day without having to worry about future tasks. Before I was using Asana, there were three big problems that I was running into. The first one was just that my to-do lists were disorganized. As much as I tried to keep them organized, there were just so many different things that I was managing that it was really tough to keep them organized. And because of this, I never knew exactly what I needed to be focusing on. The second big problem kind of just flows from the lack of organization, and that's that because things weren't organized by project and the projects weren't linearly organized, so I didn't know I needed to do this and then do this and then do this, I never really knew exactly what my next steps were. And so the prospect of getting started on any of these projects felt really overwhelming. So I often would just work on the easiest projects or the projects that I had the most clarity on and completely avoid the other ones. And then finally, and this was maybe the biggest problem of all, I had to subconsciously manage everything that was going on. All of the projects, all of the to-dos, and all of the due dates for the to-dos, because I couldn't possibly capture all of that information in a to-do list. And it seemed like it'd be a waste of time to try because it was all in my brain anyway, and it would take so much effort to get it onto the to-do list, and it probably wouldn't even be that useful because it wouldn't be organized enough to be really useful. So I was using a large part of my brain just to keep track of all of this and make sure that nothing slipped through the cracks. Asana has really fixed all of these problems for me because it's a complete system, almost like a machine, that is managing all of my projects and then keeping all of the tasks organized in those projects. So essentially, instead of having this long rambling list of to-dos, it's like all of the to-dos have been sorted into projects. And that means that I can take all of that information that I was storing in my brain, due dates and just notes about the projects and things that needed to get done for the projects, and I can put them into the projects themselves, and it actually is useful in the projects because it's gonna stay there with the project. I'm not gonna lose it because it's very digitally attached to it, and whenever I'm doing a task related to a project, I can easily see all of that information that I have added into the project. So it just means that I was able to kind of download all of that information from my brain, which has really freed up my mental capacity to be able to instead have more energy and attention to focus on actually getting the things done. Obviously, this also means that all of the tasks in the projects are really organized, so I always know what the next steps are, so I don't feel overwhelmed anymore. Okay, so now let's go a little bit deeper. Let me share with you the projects that are some of the most important projects in my business and how we use each of them. So first of all, over here in the list of projects, we've got these different categories. The first category is for internal tasks. So these are just basic things that need to be done in order to keep the business running smoothly. Mostly it has to do with customer service stuff and then financial stuff. So this will just take care of kind of the admin side of the business. So one of the projects is customer service. This is where we put issues that for some reason need to be resolved outside of the email service that we use. So they don't just need an email answer, something needs to be done with them. And then another one we've got here is the internal day-to-day. This project is organized into daily tasks and weekly tasks and monthly tasks and quarterly tasks. And each of these tasks is set to repeat. So when the designated person completes the task and hits this check mark, then at the correct interval, whatever interval we set it to repeat at, it will reappear. So for example, I've got this task right here that says I should respond to YouTube comments and it's assigned to me. And when I check it off, then the next day, the same task will reappear and I will do it again. The next category we've got here is the marketing category. This is where a lot of the heavy lifting in my business happens because this is where we create all the content for the YouTube channel. So I've got one project here just for video ideas that I've got organized by topic. Then I have another project for the production schedule. I'll get more into this in just a minute. And then we have one for just the editorial calendar. This manages all the content that we're making and how the content interacts with each other. And then we've got the blog management project for managing our blog posts. Then we have this category here called templates, and this actually has some projects in here that we don't actually work in the projects, but they already have all of the tasks created in them for some projects that we do in the business on a recurring basis. And so that saves us so much time from having to rebuild all of these projects with certain types of projects that have beginnings and endings, but then we have to do them again. Now, this category I normally keep closed because we don't actually work in those projects. The next category here is products and programs. So this is where we are managing each of the products that we sell. This allows us to store information about the products, to make sure that we are getting everything done that we need to in order to continue to run the programs that we do. And it also means that we can schedule maintenance for the programs. So if there are things that need to be updated on a regular basis, we can put tasks into these projects so that those things don't slip through the cracks. The next category here is the executive category, and this is where we do a lot of the planning for the business. So we've got this project called Meeting Agenda, and this is specifically for my weekly meeting with my operations manager. Her and I will both come in here and we will add things that we need to talk about or work on into our issues list. And then up at the top here, we have a list of things that we need to work through in every meeting, such as reviewing the business's scorecard or working on some of our regular projects that are currently on the agenda. And then in this one called Quarterly Initiatives, we plan out the next 3 months of the year and we plan which projects we're gonna work on in each of those months. And this helps us to know what we are prioritizing. So instead of just constantly working a little bit on this and a little bit on that, every single month we have these priorities that we planned at the beginning of the month or at the beginning of the quarter, and that really helps us to stay focused and to get these projects done rather than letting them just go on forever. The final category here is the branding and design category, and it just has a couple projects that store some information about the visual design of some of the aspects of the business. Okay, so let's go back up to that YouTube production schedule because this project is probably the project that I spend the very most time in every single week because creating these videos for YouTube is honestly the most intense thing that I do. So here's how this works. We create these tasks or these micro projects here in this column that says to plan. And then after the video gets planned, then we can move it into the to film category, which tells me and the rest of my team that that video is ready to film. Then once it's filmed, we can move it over into the to edit column to tell the editors that they can run with it and make it ready to get revised. So that pushes it back to me where I then review their edit and then I'll tell them if there's any additional changes that need to be made. Then we can put it in the to schedule category, which tells my operations manager that she can go ahead and schedule it on YouTube. And from there, we move it into the published category to essentially archive it, but still keep all the details about the project. Now, what's really cool about these projects, well, two different things. One is that inside of them, there's a lot of information. First of all, there are details about the video. Now, this one hasn't been planned yet, so there aren't really details here yet, but you can see the sorts of things that we put in here. And then there are all these subtasks, because in order to produce a video start to finish, there are a lot of little things that need to be done. We have to outline the video contents, we have to plan out the shots, we need to write the description that the video will eventually be published with, do some keyword research, film the A-roll, film the B-roll, and then create the YouTube thumbnail, and on all the way through finally getting it uploaded. So in order to make sure that nothing slips through the cracks, we have a task for every single one of those things that needs to get checked off. Now, this is a lot of work in order to manage all this, but what makes it a lot easier is the ability to duplicate tasks. So you can just hit these three dots, and this is our template task for producing a video, and then you can click duplicate task and type in the name of it. And then when you hit create new task, it will copy all of those subtasks and that structure that we created for the details of the video, and that will all be here ready to go for this new video without us having to type it all in again, which saves so much time. Okay, so the last little thing I want to show you is just how easy Asana makes it to delegate things. So if you have a team, even a tiny team of people who help you with things, this is so cool. So when you make a task, you can use the task as a micro project. So here, I'll just call this one project, just for an example. And you can add, of course, any sort of details into the description of the task. And then you can create these subtasks. And so maybe we need to plan the project, create designs, organize designs, and then publish designs. But if I don't want to do all of these things myself, or if I can't do them all myself, then I can assign each of them to someone else with a particular due date. And what's so cool about this is that not only will each of these people get these tasks onto their to-do list on the right day without me having to tell them to do these things, but also I can add more information here so that they have everything that they need in order to complete their tasks. So like maybe they need some links in order to be able to do these things, or maybe they need some files. So I can go in here and attach any files that they need, and then it will just attach to that task, and then they'll have access to those files so that they'll be able to have everything they need and get it done on time without having to come back to me and ask me for things to do this work. Before I was using Asana, I had to spend so much, or like use so much of my mental capacity just to run my business, and I wasn't even doing that good of a job of it. But now, because Asana is keeping track of everything for me, when I'm not working, I don't have to think about work, because I don't have to make sure that I'm not forgetting anything. I don't have to make sure I don't miss any deadlines or anything like that. Asana's just like keeping track of it all for me. So when I'm not working, when I'm out of the office, I can focus on life and not think about my business at all. Also, just in case you missed this earlier in the video, Asana is totally free. There is a pro version also that gives you even more features, and I do use the pro version, but even the free version is incredibly awesome and will really help you to organize any sort of projects that you have going on, whether it be running a business or anything else. All right, well, that is all for this video, but if you want to learn even more about how I run my business and how I work for myself, then make sure you subscribe, because I make new videos about those things every single week, and I would love it if you join me for the next one. Also, just if you have any questions about my Asana setup or how I organize or manage my business, feel free to ask in the comments below. I always check the comment section, and I try to answer every single question that comes in the first 24 hours at least, and even after that first 24 hours after the video comes out, I'm always scrolling through the comments, so I will get you an answer if I see your question. So if you have any questions, ask me down there. Otherwise, I'll see you next week.